A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away, we had Star Wars, baby! Yes, I'm talking about Star Wars! It dominated the world, captured our childhoods, became one of the greatest sci-fi series of all time, with deep lore, dramatic and heart-crushing storytelling. I mean, the music, the fights! And then one day, the dark side rose. The Disney Empire, led by Darth Kathleen Kennedy, took over, destroying everything we once loved about our beloved series.
Good, Anakin, good! Kill him. Kill him now.
In a few short years, they did more damage to the world, the lore, the storytelling, the history, literally everything this universe had to offer, and nearly killed Star Wars. Between box office failures, mediocre television, arguably the worst film ever created, it looked like Star Wars was done for good.
My brother, Anakin! I loved you!
Us fans needed hope. A new hope, one might say. And then came that hope. Dave motherfucking Filoni, the savior of not only Star Wars, but of Lucasfilm in general. I want to keep this video relatively brief because I really want to do a deep dive review of Ahsoka when it's fully complete, when it's done. But I can sit here today and say without a shadow of a doubt that Ahsoka is the best Star Wars thing we've gotten since Revenge of the Sith. The show has been everything to me. I mean, as someone who's been saying for years now that Star Wars is dead, that Disney killed Star Wars, that they'll never recover what they destroyed with the sequels, as the same guy that's been saying all of this for years, I can also say that I have teared up and damn near cried for 3 straight weeks watching this fucking Star Wars show. Thanks to Dave frickin' Filoni. Episode 5 of this show, and I'll go more in depth in my full review of the show, like I'll go more in depth in this episode in general, but just kind of my thoughts on it here. It's just, oh my god. Between Anakin's return, both physically and thematically to the story, and how it makes sense for the overall lore of the character, his spiritual connection with Ahsoka, and the lightsaber fight, oh my god, the lightsaber fight! The visuals as well, I mean, oh my god, I mean, look at this show. This is the best shot of the year in anything. This is the best shot of the year. It's the best shot in the universe. Great job. The episode is perfect, and this thematic and subtle storytelling of Anakin trying to teach Ahsoka this lesson, with Filoni never really telling the audience directly what that lesson is. They never look you in the eyes and say, this is what Anakin's trying to teach Ahsoka. And with this subtle writing, the audience can actually peel back the words of Anakin, the actions, the representations. You can watch this episode multiple times to get to the core of what he's actually trying to teach her. And then when you finally realize it, you go, oh my god. You start to tear up because it's, oh my god, he's teaching her the same lesson that Luke taught him when Luke decided to no longer fight Vader, that he didn't have to kill his father, and he threw away that lightsaber. That lesson of sometimes you don't have to fight. Being a Jedi is not fighting. The correct way forward is to stop fighting. Something that Ahsoka hasn't been able to do since the Clone Wars. She's just been constantly fighting ever since she was a Jedi. It's so beautiful. Oh my god. But I didn't want to do a full review of this episode until at least episode 6 came out, because it's one thing to win me over with nostalgia and with just throwing Hayden Christensen at me, but episode 6 would remove all of that nostalgia so we could see if there's actually, like, if the show's actually good. And I will save my thoughts of the episode and the themes of it, like everything on Admiral Thrawn and everything that went into it, I'll save that for my full review, but what I can say about the episode is just, oh my god. They fucking did it! They fucking did it, man! They nailed everything. And that shot of the starship entering the scene and Thrawn's first appearance, I mean,
what was first just a dream has become a frightening reality for those who may oppose us.
I'm gonna come.
Oh my god. It's brilliant. It's brilliant. I'm shaking thinking about this is Star Wars, which I thought was dead, and I'm sitting here just mind blown at the episode that I just watched. So what's the point of this video? Well, the point of the video is very simple. I just want to sit here and I want to say thank you, Dave Filoni. Thank you for making me feel like a kid again, for reminding me why I love this world so much and why these characters were so important to me for so long. Thank you, and please just Don't let Kathleen Kennedy get in that writer's room. Just please, keep her out. Lock the door. Don't let her touch this or anything. Just get her out of Star Wars, please. Because The Rise of Skywalker, I've talked about it so much on this channel, but it is the most disgraceful thing to ever happen to Hollywood. It is an absolute disgrace. But yeah, that's the video. I hope you guys like it. Make sure to like this video and subscribe for more. Make sure to turn on notifications to see everything as I post it. And I will see you guys in the next one. Star Wars is fucking back, baby.
We are back, baby. We are fucking back. We're back.